It's time for another kit build on HPI Guys Workshop. Today I'm going to be putting together the 125th scale 1967 Camaro Z28 from AMT. It's in this cool retro boxing. We can see some of the options that are going to be in the box for the kit. We got some side pipes, we got chrome valve covers, we got a set of custom wheels in there, and those wheels look very, very 90-ish to me. So we could see the engine in there under the hood. Let's take a look. We'll start looking at the white plastic this time in white styrene. We've got our small block with transmission molded in one. We got a belt and pulley system. We got separate alternator, distributor. We got some shocks on here. We got optional hood hinges, front suspension. We've got our rear suspension in one piece, oil pan. We got a battery there, fans, fan shrouds, all on the motive power parts tree. On this one here, we've got some body parts. We've got our spoiler, steering, drive shaft, and different body moldings. Look like we've got some holes here to mount our bumpers, so that's cool. I always enjoy when those are in there. It makes our build a lot easier. Then we've got our optional hood headers. Got the hood opened up for the blower. We got our wheelbacks there. Blower belt, dual carburetor setup. Got the intake right there for the blower, so we do have engine options. On this one, we've got our nice stock Z28 hood. More wheelbacks, dual exhaust system, manifolds, stock carburetor, air cleaner, valve covers, intake for the stock system on that tree. Under the hood on the stock hood is a very nice looking stamped out frame with slits for those hood hinges if you want to use them. On this tree here, we've got a different radiator and intake system. We've got our fancy 90s style wheels, shocks and suspension, another air cleaner on there, kinds of option parts in the kit. Here we've got our stock dashboard, steering wheel, beautiful bucket seats, and seat backs. Our chassis is here. You can see it's not that big of a car. Nowadays they'd be considered big. Back then they were considered, you know, sport midsize. Nice detail on there. Crisp and clean. Looks like the suspension is molded in on the top, so it should help us to make sure that the car sits level when we're all done. The interior tub has a lot molded in it. It's got all the door panels, the rear seat, the center console, and the little gauge cluster down there is all molded in place, along with the three-pedal system all the way around the sides there. And our Camaro body is next up. We've got our trim piece here, strong molded in. Door handles, windshield braces, we'll cut these out. Got our windshield wipers and our vents molded in. Got pretty much the entire firewall and the fenders all molded in place. So if you're not doing a black car, I think these would all end up being black, all three of those, and around the front, so you'd have to hand paint those. Go around the back, see our tail lights. Got our gas cap right there, molded in. Good detail and relief on it. We can get that chromed pretty easily. Can do this trim easily, and the door handles. So that's looking good on there for the 67. We'll go to the other side of the table and pull out a set of six tires. We've got a set of little bit widers and taller tires in the back. No name brand. Bias ply tread. That'll be if you put the blower on it or if you just want the back end to sit higher. A lot of people had that stuff on there and their car didn't have the power to spin those. We've got a set of stock tires on there. These look like Goodyears to me. We can talk about that as soon as I get my magnifying glasses on. There is no white letter tire option in this kit, which it kind of screams for in a Z28 to me. But these are the stock tires with their tread. These are a solid rubber, so the wheels will push in from either side. We've got our windshield glass and our side lights. One piece with the separate side lights molded in. Chrome tree, we've got our side pipes, our lake pipes, side pipes. We've got our chrome valve covers, blower parts. Beautiful stock wheels. Love the rally wheels. Got our stock grille on there, and the headlights are molded in, so we'll have to black wash everything in there. Got a chrome air cleaner. We've got one mirror on there. We've got velocity stacks. We've got our thin bumpers, our real skinny, skinny bumpers on there, and our taillights. All molded on that chrome tree. Finally, in the kit, we will come across our decal sheet. Liking these decals. They are split together so we can put them on the hood and the trunk. They've got the pinstripe built into them. We've also got gauge clusters, two complete sets, and two complete sets of Chevrolet and Camaro emblems all the way through. 67 plates, USA 1. We've got those nice stripes in white, black, and silver. And that is a nice metallic silver too, very attractive. So it's a great decal sheet. As always, when they put those gauges in there, the radios, temperature control and stuff really helps out. Some under hood badging and whatnot on there. So excellent, we've got tons of license plates and the AMT logos on there. That is everything that's in the box. I'm gonna put together my 67 Z28. Be back in a second. Thank you. Up to this point, the build has not presented any challenges at all. I was even surprised at how nicely the valances fit on the body. I mean, it's a really nice fit. This one here, I'll compress a little more as I go. But otherwise, we've got a great seam line on the back. You could always work on that with a little bit of putty and make it absolutely perfect. But right out of the box, which is the way I build for the reviews, we're not going to have any problems with that at all. Looks sharp. It's a nice looking Camaro body. I'm going to enjoy the build up, especially with my paint idea. So we'll look at some other stuff. There's not a ton to do on the kit before you go to paint. I've glued the exhaust together, which you can install in one piece as long as you leave the differential out. And the differential is one large piece with large locating pegs that go into the chassis here. So there's absolutely no reason why I can't paint that separately by holding onto the axle and get that painted up a different tone than the body, and then attach the shock absorbers later as we go and I get those painted a nice color. Even the front suspension on this kit, which sometimes when they have kingpins like this will give you an issue, well, they key themselves in to that solid suspension on the top. They actually go into a square hole, and then they key in right there as well on the corners. So you really can't screw this up too bad. I mean, if there anyone can, I can, and it has went together quite easy. Then we've got the lower suspension and the engine cradle and stuff like that. So that glues in, pushes into the holes, lines up with the pins. We shouldn't have any problem. As you can see, what I like to do a lot on the little stuff that's directional is I like to write the part numbers on them with magic marker. The paint will cover it right up. You won't have a problem with it. So that's going to go together. I've also got that tunnel there glued in, that brace there. The interior needs nothing. Well, I cut simply other parts off so I can get them painted easier. We got our belt pulley and fan and alternator glued together. We got the radiator glued together. That small block is a very nice representation, even as an oil filler neck. Distributor, single four barrel carb. I'm building a stock Camaro. Got our manifolds on there, which are nicely shaped, and a nice looking starter and solenoid. So that comes out without any problems. Everything pushes together. There's no big gaps between the heads and the intake. There's no gap on the back, on the front. Water pump goes on fine without any issue, no problems. And then we got the seats. Even the seat backs fit together. No gaps or anything. I build out of the box so that everyone can see how they go. And that's what I like to do for most of my builds, is I just build them right out of the box. So we've got all that taken care of. I'm going to be using the stock hood and the wheel backs. Because of the body paint color, I can just leave the wheel backs on there. And in case you wanted to use those lake pipes, those side pipes, whatever you decide you like to call them, I did glue the headers together just so you could see that they go together. There is a little bit of a gap. Clamp them tighter onto that flange and then glue them again, but I just did a basic glue from the center. I would want to line up where they connect to the collector and where they collect to the head, put some more glue on them once they're together and hold them. But they are a nice set of headers and could be using a lot of other stuff. So we're going to get everything over to paint right now, and I will see you over there. Thank you.
Rico. Estamos mayo ladito. A toda mi gente de Puerto Rico. A la familia Fontané. Allá en Cupe Alto y Lo Mejía en Vega Baja. ¡Que goce! ¡Hey!
Bomba, bomba, para siempre.
Bomba, bomba, está presente. Aquí lo canta mi gente.
Bomba, bomba, para siempre.
Baila, baila.
We'll be right back.
a final look at the chassis, engine, and package before we put the car together, and then we will have our final fits. Now, I don't brag a lot about the work I do and stuff like that, because I'm not into that, but I really did impress myself with those white letters on the tires. Now, they're not perfectly clear. That's a very small molding, and you'll see imperfections, but man, doing it the way you saw me do it on screen there, that looks really good. And a Camaro like this, I think, needs raised white letter tires. It just enhances the look so much, and those rally wheels are really attractive. So I'm glad that I tried that, and you saw how I protected those and everything. And the reason I used acrylic, the reason I use acrylic paint and acrylic sprays on this is because enamels will never dry on a vinyl surface. It'll stay wet and gooey. It will never dry, but acrylics will dry completely, and they'll dry nice and fast. I've got the interior done. The only thing you really didn't see me do was the silver trim with just a marker around the gauges and stuff. On the very bottom, those that three cluster gauge, there's no decals that I could see for that on the decal sheet. So I just used a silver Sharpie and then dabbed a little bit of black in the center to make those little gauge clusters. Put the shifter in, and we got our black on black with that fall wood steering wheel they put in the Z28s. So that's all set to go. I've got to attach my bumpers and my rear view mirror and my air cleaner towards the end. We'll look at the body that nose pushes in. My Mod Podge headlights definitely look like glass now, and the black wash in there and everything. All of these parts, this just pushes into the grill, but where the grill attaches to the parts tree, you'll need to take a knife and shave that down. It's a very tight fit in here, and if you leave those nibs on, you're gonna see that one side keeps popping out and popping loose. But we got the grill in. Yes, I did chrome trim around that body molding. Wouldn't normally be that way, but I thought on this cool silver car, this kind of darker silver, I thought, you know, a classier salesman's car, executive's Camaro, he would have had a piece of chrome trim installed by the dealer just to enhance it a little bit. The taillights go in from the back, and they look awesome, just glued into place. The only fitment that I'm not a big fan of are these side windows. I've got them Mod Podged in place, but I still don't like how they fit in there. They kind of interfere with the windshield and the back glass, so they kind of fight you a little bit. Under the hood, I've got the heater core, the wiper motor, the brake booster, the battery, and then I painted that black by hand, which came out quite nice, and then did a black wash in those vents, which isn't going to matter much because there's going to be decals going in that anyway. So that, I like that paint that I'm using. It's like a gray, almost a gold, but it's a little bit of like kind of a lighter gray and stuff mixed in with it, so it looks pretty cool on the car. I think you could build Buddy Repperton's car from Christine out of this 67 if you just source different wheels, but we've got the stripes, we've got the body, we could really get close with that. We've got the engine in the chassis, which pushes in with no issue. The radiator locks into the cross mount there and glues in. The radiator hose, the belt and pulley system. And then underneath, you saw me glue it together, and then I attached the shocks at the end and the traction bar to get it all in there. Painted that gas tank, the exhaust, everything just lines up the way it should and looks good to me. So all I've got to do is slip everything together, put my stripes on, I'll have the final. We are checking out the completed 1968 Chevy Camaro Z28 from AMT, reissued by Round 2 Models on the bench. This would be a good replica of Buddy Repperton's car in Christine. You could easily make one. You would just have to source different wheels on that car, but otherwise, the striping package is there, the interior is there, it's a Z28. It is awesome. So I did my own little version of the sweet metallic gray. I put white stripes on it because I figured with the white stripes, the chrome trim, the dark metallic, and I did the little bit of trim on the bottom, which really isn't trim, but anyone who bought it could have enhanced it when they owned it. I thought that the white stripes would just add a little bit of classiness to the ride. Instead of going black and making it too dark, it's got the black on black interior. So I figured brighten up the exterior with a little bit of white striping. You can do whatever you want with yours. You've got all the options. Well, I could have even ghost striped it with these silver ones, which are a lighter tone than the silver that's on the car. That would have looked pretty cool as well. Or the black, or whatever you want to do. You want to have a non-stripe Z28? You want to have a Z28 with a spoiler, with different wheels and tires. It's up to you. They do have the more 90s style Z, I call them Z wheels, because they got that like slant to them, like the letter Z. So you could put those on there if you wanted. The decals in the back, if you're not going to use the spoiler, do have to be trimmed. And in fact, I can see that now that I'm looking at it go around, I could use a little bit of a better trim on mine on the rear. But if you use a spoiler, they'll go up and over and around. If you don't, you're going to have to remove about a quarter inch of spoiler on the back, which is what I'll have to finish trimming up and all that on mine. So great kit, easy goes together. Putting it together at the end is quite easy. The interior pushes up tightly, so it didn't need any glue to hold it in place inside the body. And then that snaps over the chassis. Put the rear in first. There is a small shelf in the rear that the back of the car will push up against. Don't go over it, go under it. Push it against it, and then snap your front end into the front of the car. If you need to attach your valances at the end, the way they fit when I was gluing them on was quite smooth, so I don't think that would be a problem at all. Overall, very easy build, and you saw we could even get some white letter tires right out of the box on the model. The rally wheels on this car are super sharp. I like them. They are very attractive. They look everything like the box top and could be enhanced by the master painters to mask them off and get that argent on the inside and the chrome on the outside just right. I do my trick with the matte clear and then the black wash to enhance them as far as I want to go and get that toyish chrome off of them. The bumpers just push into those pinholes that we saw. In fact, the rear bumper is glued on. The front bumper is just friction fit. The nose and the grill look good. Use that Mod Podge gloss in the lights, and they will end up looking like you actually put plastic lights in them. The only thing I didn't really like about the kit is these side vent windows. And messing with it, I did end up pushing one a little in. I tried to pull it out a little bit. Didn't quite work, but trying to get the interior in and the body on, these just want to push loose. So nothing we can really do about that. In fact, you know, if I were to do it again, I'd probably leave them out. Most people wouldn't even notice that they were gone. But yeah, that was the only thing of the kit. And that's more my not having time to wait for everything to dry on those perfectly than it is a fault of the kit. They would work. I just have to wait longer and I'm impatient and I like to build super fast. So I've only got about 7-8 hours into this kit at most. And it doesn't include drying time, but that's how easy it goes together. Nice little V8 underneath the hood. You can deck it out. You can put that blower on there. You can put those velocity stacks like it shows. We've got all the options in the box. And that's how you should do it, is build yours for you so that I can see all of you at the next review.